Welcome. See this sum. We have to find all the roots of x to the power 5 plus 1 equals to 0. So from here we can easily write x to the power 5 equals to minus 1. And we can say easily that x equals to minus 1. Because we are knowing minus 1 to the power 5 equals to minus 1. So we can say one of the root is minus 1. But remember, here the original equation, the maximum power of x is 5. So it should have 5 roots. That means, and we are getting from here one root. The remaining 4 roots should be a complex quantity. Complex roots always remain in pairs. So, since 2 pairs will be there, altogether 5 roots will be there, we are getting mentally itself one root will be minus 1. That means there will be 4 other complex roots. How to find those things? I am showing one thing. Step by step we can see x plus iy we can write as r into cos theta plus I sin theta. This one we get it, that is from Cartesian form. If we are transferring to polar form, we are getting this one. So this is now x plus I y whole to the power n equals to what it will be there, r to the power n into cos theta plus I sin theta whole to the power n. Now, you are knowing De Moivre's theorem. According to that theorem, this one can be written as r to the power n into cos n theta plus I sin n theta. These things we will apply to solve this question. Now see, here we can write x to the power 5 equals to minus 1, we are knowing it is I square, or x equals to I to the power 2 by 5. Now see what we can write. I equals to, in this form if we are writing, it can be written as cos pi by 2 plus I sin pi by 2. As you are knowing, cos pi by 2 is 0 and sin pi by 2 is 1, so it is becoming I. So I to the power 2 by 5 can be written as cos pi by 2 plus I sin pi by 2 whole to the power 2 by 5. This equals to, we can write cos 2k pi plus pi by 2 into 2 by 5 plus I sin 2k pi plus pi by 2 into 2 by 5. This one is coming as if we are multiplying by 2, cos 1 by 5 into 4 k pi plus pi plus I sin 1 by 5 into 4 k pi plus pi. This one can be again, you can take pi common. Okay, that's not important. Now the 5 roots will be, how we will get it? By putting k equals to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. By these 5 values of k, you will get 5 roots. So this is your answer. I am just showing it. If you are putting k equals to 0, then what is coming? Cos k is 0. So cos pi by 5 plus I sin pi by 5. If you are putting k equals to 1, then 5 pi by 5, that is cos 5 pi by 5, that is cos pi plus I sin pi. And this is cos pi equals to minus 1, sin pi equals to 0. You are getting x equals to minus 1. From here actually we are getting x equals to minus 1, only real root. Other than if we are putting x equals k equals to 2, then it is cos eight pi plus by 9 pi by 5 plus I sin 9 pi by 5, and x equals to 3, we are getting 13 pi, cos 13 pi by 5 plus I sin 13 pi by 5. X equals to 4, we are getting 4 the 16, 17, cos 17 pi by 5 plus I sin 17 pi by 5. So in this way we are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and only one root is real, all others are imaginary. Complex roots. All others are complex roots, and this is only real root. Thank you.